G'day and welcome to something new, something different. Although it looks very familiar because I'm on the alien planet. What I'm thinking of doing here is starting a short series where I'm going to try and visit every single planet. But the thing that's going to make this a bit different to the usual series that I do is that this one is 100% vanilla because I'm playing on one of Keen's public servers. And that means there are a lot of PvP elements and things like that that I'm going to have to think about, and other little bits and pieces like that that I'm going to have to consider as I go along. Things like limited PCU, which I'm definitely not accustomed to dealing with, that sort of stuff. And the reason I wanted to do this was because I wanted to get a reminder of what the vanilla multiplayer experience was like. And what better way to do it than to play some vanilla multiplayer. Let's get some stone produced. What I'm going to do today is try and get myself off the alien planet as quickly as possible so that I can get to space and get myself safe from anyone finding me while I'm offline. Or at least as safe as I can manage to be. I'll probably want to collect as much in terms of specific ores while I'm on the alien planet as I can, because it's quite difficult and time consuming to find ores when you're out in space. Asteroids, being as far apart as they are, it takes a fair bit of time to find enough asteroids for all the different stuff that you need. For obvious reasons, I'm not doing this as a stream, because then people will know exactly where I am. And I've done that in the past, and while it's fun, there are some challenges in allowing people to hunt you down. Some of them, and they end badly. All right, we need to make a couple of things. I'm going to need to produce a couple of those. I'll need some girders at least for the wind turbines so I can get quickly up a basic assembler, basic refinery, and a wind turbine. That way I can start building something that should be able to get me to space and off this rock towards the end of this recording. Another challenge for me, and something that I don't normally deal with, is the fact that I'm not going to be able to play with any scripts. There's no solar tracking scripts. There's none of those scripts that I normally use. I can't use build vision. I can't use all that sort of stuff. So it's going to change how I play a fair bit from what I normally do. I'm going to try and avoid hand mining as much as possible because that's going to slow me down. The quicker I can get a drill ship up and running, the better. And being vanilla rather than what I've been playing recently with all of the challenging mods or, you know, Capac, I should be able to get something up and running fairly quickly, I think. Though, it's been a while since I've done this with the attempt being as fast as possible, so I may well make a few mistakes as I go along. Alright, tower for wind turbine parts, basic assembler parts, and basic refinery parts. Another 1500 iron and another little bit of nickel, so that won't be too hard to get. One downside of doing this on the public server is that I can't set up a spectator camera for myself. Because I don't have admin rights to make someone creative mode so they don't die. So no time lapses, unfortunately. Sounds like we're playing with realistic sounds. It's quite different. I like it. I haven't played with it in a very long time. The server I'm on at the moment is very quiet. I am not going to be playing at any particular time of day. I don't have any plans around that. It'll just be fitting in this recording between Survival Unlikely and Survival Impossible and just seeing what I can do. So my overall goal with this is to do the grand tour, is to get to every planet in vanilla as quickly as I can, starting with the alien planet. Then I'll head off to Titan, to Mars, to Europa. Whoa. There goes a piece of rock being ejected. And then I'll head to the moon and finally Earth. Earth being the last stop and where I will do something a little bit special to finish this off. Maybe even streaming it live if I can work out a time that works nicely. And if I decide to do the stream thing, then I really can't afford to tell anyone what server I'm on, because then I might not be able to get on myself. If too many people try to get on. But that's all part of the fun of finding out what the experience is like for people who just test out these servers. I want to see what it is like, because so many people ask me about this stuff and I just don't have a good answer for them. I don't know enough about how it's all working these days. It's been so long since I've played straight up vanilla multiplayer. The last time I played multiplayer on an open server was during the multiplayer tests. That is a long while ago. So I feel like my knowledge of that area is getting a bit out of date. I'm also hoping that this will be a thing for 2020 is a bunch of little mini challenges like this that run over a few weeks that are going to be somewhere between 5 and 10 episodes each. And if you've got any ideas of challenges like that that might be that completable in that sort of time frame, I am very interested to hear your thoughts. Because I've got a few others lined up that I hope to do throughout the year, but you can never use too many ideas. One of the nice things about this server being quiet at the moment is that these rocks are not disappearing. Because there are few other people online, that means that there are few other floating objects. How are we going? We're almost there for iron, aren't we? Something else I decided for this challenge is that to make it a little bit more interesting, I'm only going to allow myself to have one spawn point at any time. That means I have to bring all my valuable stuff with me if I don't want to spawn miles away from whatever I'm using to move around. So it'll be a little bit of an Iron Man mode-ish challenge. I don't mind if my engineer gets killed, but if I lose my spawn point, then it's done. We're over. And we'll start something new at that point. So this could go horribly wrong if someone decides to fight me or find me or pick on me. But that's all part of the experience too. And that's kind of why I thought that would be a fun thing to do. It'll mean I have to think more carefully about what position I put my spawn point in, especially as I don't recall checking what the refinery efficiencies were for the default servers. And if they're low, getting any platinum for some ion thrusters is going to be quite difficult. So if there are space pirates out there, or if there are trading stations, that might be the better way to go to get some ion thrusters or that sort of thing so that I can move around in space without having to worry about using any, without having to keep refueling my hydrogen ship. So what I need for today is to get a large grid hydrogen ship or a small grid hydrogen ship with enough equipment to make a large grid start out in space. And I'll probably have to go that angle. Something small grid, but with a big enough cargo to include all of this stuff and probably some, well, maybe enough stuff for the bigger refineries actually would be the better way to go. I think we have enough resources. Yes, we do. Excellent. So now I can get to welding. I think my first goal should be is to refit the respawn pod. My first goal should be, while I've still got a little bit of light, find some cobalt. Fortunately, I'm in the snow, so spotting any ore deposits is going to be difficult. Is that an ore discoloration? A reddish patch? I don't think it is. Could be though. Nope. I don't actually know what the ore patches look like on the planet, I'm just realizing. Oh, dang it. Oh, great. How am I gonna find any ores if I don't know what the ore patches look like? Oh, that is a discoloration. That is definitely a discoloration. What do we got here? There we go. Nickel and magnesium. I don't know if that gets sent out globally, so I'm just gonna do it this way. I haven't actually checked whether the GPS commands are sent out to everyone. If there's anything that shows up for other players when you do that. I might have to check that with Capac before I go and broadcast to everybody what I'm doing. Alright, that is... how much have I got? Hydrogen left, 65%. And that's one ore deposit. Marked. Got nickel and mag, that's good. I want to see if I can quickly find some cobalt. So if I can get some cobalt, then we can upgrade the lander into a mining... a flying mining ship. This is another deposit here. You can see there's a light grey speckling in this area. Bit of uneven colouring on these rocks. There's iron. So if I don't find the cobalt before morning, that is going to make my life quite challenging. I can turn the respawn pod into something that'll fly around, and I could go hunting down... Well, I could go chasing the sun, really. But I'd rather not have to do that. I mean, right now, it's just producing a whole bunch of stuff anyway for me. So... This does seem like a valid use of my time. Oh, wait! Splitsie, you're a dope. I'm not playing with my usual nighttime is horribly dark mod. So nighttime's not going to be as dark as I'm used to. Because this is full vanilla. Nighttime, I should still be able to see enough to do some things. Is that speckled patch? Could be. I might need to head home after this one. Silver. Oh, excellent. Silver. I can get myself a medbay. And cobalt. Perfect. All right. Let's grab some cobalt while I'm here. Assuming I'm not going to run out of energy before I get down to it. Come on. You can do it before I run out. Just let me get a little bit of cobalt. Enough to get a few grids so that I can fly my lander around. I probably don't want to have broadcast on that I've left on this whole time. Just in case anyone ends up anywhere near me, I would rather them not be able to identify me that easily. Okay, I have 8% left in my bottle. Got enough cobalt to do what I need to do, so I'm heading home. 4 power remaining. Let's turn off my inertial dampeners. Make this flight profile a little more efficient. Oh, nuts. I should have GPS'd that mine exit. It may be a little difficult to spot, even though I know where the cobalt is. I don't want to have to drill all that way down again. Oh dear. Connection problem. Ooh, geez. Okay. there's a problem I wasn't anticipating with using inertial dampeners off. If I have a connection issue, I'm dead. All right, we have zero power. And we're back. Easy. All right, basic assembler is up and running, or will be in a second. That'll allow me to build the tubes I need to build more thrusters, which is why I went straight for these. Getting mobile early on a server like this, I think, is really important. But anything I say that's relevant to PvP, you got to take with a big grain of salt, because I haven't done a lot of it, to be honest. One of the things I really like about Space Engineers is designing stuff that's pretty, designing stuff that looks interesting and looks fun. So... to then go and have someone else blow it up kind of takes a lot of the fun out of it for me. So I don't tend to play much in modes where people can break my stuff. I'm okay if it's an NPC breaking my stuff because, well, I can then learn from that interaction and I can usually mitigate the damage pretty well so that it's something that's not the end of a thing. But more, I can control when I fight them. So if I do have something that I would absolutely be devastated if I lost, I wouldn't bring it into an encounter. Whereas in a PvP environment, that's not usually an option. You don't get to choose when the engagements happen in most situations. So you have to be willing to lose all your stuff. I may go grab myself a load of most of these ores, although there's not much point getting the silver just yet. Until I have the proper refinery, I can't really do anything with it. So you might be wondering why I'm going after ores instead of just building a piston-mounted drill rig and drilling straight into the rock. And the reasoning for me behind that is if I were to build a piston-mounted rig, it's fixed. I can't really move it, at least at this stage, because I'm not going to be able to put it on wheels or on thrusters. So it's not really the most effective way for me to get materials. What I'd rather do is quickly get enough to get mobile. And once I'm mobile, then I can consider things like that. But once I'm mobile, I shouldn't need them. Yeah, this is going to get me plenty of iron. All right. So, respawn pod. I really want to get you with a cockpit instead of the seat. So let's grab the gun, ammo, and the GPS of the base out of there. Quickly reweld the landing gear because that's a block unlock. Alrighty, and get rid of a few of these. I should be able to walk in. If I grind off that, I might need to do this quickly to unlock the blocks. There we go. Now I'll have conveyor blocks because if I put into this little spot here that I just opened up one of these. The cockpit will be piped up to the rest of the system that's already existing in this little drop pod. So a regular cockpit has the port in the right spot to get hooked up that way. Just so that we don't run into power problems, I'm going to place a couple of extra turbines on here. And while they're being produced, I'll go grab some nickel to make sure I've got plenty of nickel for motors so that I can get some atmospheric thrusters up and running. Nickel, magnesium this way. I'm hearing a background sound that sounds like cockroaches or spiders crawling across something. I don't believe the Saberoids in the normal servers here, and I would have thought I would have run into them if they were already, so I would already be dead. I think I'm safe, but it's still playing those sound effects, which is kind of creepy. Right, turbine 2 is up. Probably don't need 3, but I'm just going to do 3 anyway. Ow. That was a little fast into the ground. Cockpit's up. I'll stick a drill on the front of it, and then I'll start getting some thrusters on there, putting a large cargo on there so that I can accumulate parts. And we should be almost good to get mobile. And then it's only a matter of getting some hydrogen thrust on it, collecting enough bits and pieces that I won't have to hunt through asteroids to get stuff, because that's something I really don't want to have to do. I don't want to have to be going from asteroid to asteroid hunting for resources. It's really quite a slow way of finding stuff. Despite the dangers of a planet and the challenges of having to deal with gravity, a planet is actually a much quicker place to find resources because of those ore deposit markers, and the ores are usually not anywhere near as spread out. And let's turn off this blink. It's going to drive me insane. The thing I really need to find is some gold for a jump drive, and I'm definitely going to want to get some platinum, so heading to Titan relatively early is going to be high on my priority list. But there's not much point heading to Titan until I have a space and at least moon, but hopefully planet capable ship, so that I can get down to Titan, pick up the platinum and refine it in the ship that I'm actually flying in. So I'm all moving as one and not having to make journeys back and forth and leaving something unprotected up in space. So I'm thinking is large cargo container off the back here, maybe like that. Do I want to go drill at the front of this thing? Probably could make it flyable and drillable, like able to be used as a drill ship. Yeah, I will go that way. Better to combine everything into one ship for the time being, and then once I collect enough materials that I could put down a large refinery, I can then go and do stuff like making a large grid ship. But I might want to do that in space rather than trying to do that on the planet to start off with, because if I can get to space, that'll be a much safer place for me to build something that takes as long as a large grid ship, even though I'm going to be going quite compact for it. Right, so we're going to need a bunch more thrust. Have I unlocked thrusters yet? Yes, I have. Now, I've got a PCU limit in this, so I want to go large thrusters if I can, since a large thruster has the same PCU as a small one, but obviously gives me more thrust, so there's an advantage to it from that perspective. And I do have quite a tight PCU limit on this server. We go large thruster, large thruster. I'm gonna need more iron. All right, can do. Let's drop everything off so I'm not carrying unnecessary stuff. I'm quite fortunate with my connection to the server that I'm playing on. I do have a ping of less than 100 pretty much all the time, so the lag is really quite tolerable. It's not a big issue. It's really not something I have to worry about too much. And it's kind of, the ping I've got is about as good as you ever get with space engineers. It's normally hovering about 80-ish. So I can't really blame ping-related issues if I faceplant into something. Though if I get a nice little connection glitch, I can blame that. Surely? Okay, we have one large atmo. That should give me enough for the two. Then I just need to add some directionals and a bit more battery power. And a drill, or three. And when I come back with a load of iron, I will build a connector onto this base so that I can quickly offload, refine a bunch of stuff. It's actually going reasonably well. I've been playing now for about 40 minutes and have already managed to get a fair way through what I wanted to get through. So I shouldn't need little lifting thrusters, I hope. Which means I can repurpose them to be directionals. I could have gotten this moving much more cheaply had I gone with just a remote control and then popped a couple of extra bits on it. But I was thinking of this being more useful than that. Rather than just being some way I could move to somewhere else, because I found the cobalt as quickly as I did, I really wasn't fussed with hanging here just a bit longer and collecting what I needed to make this thing a bit more useful. A bit more long-term useful, I should say. Given the weight of this, I would like to have two directional thrusters minimum in each direction. I'm fairly comfortable with keeping my ships level at all times. That kind of means that I can get away with minimal... That means I can get away with minimal directionals. Oh. Really? How is that the block that I'm highlighting? Really gotta pay more attention to the little thing on the right. So we go there and there. Possibly sounds a little overconfident to say, oh, I'll be fine. I've flown lots of things that require me to keep it perfectly level. I've flown and crashed many things that require me to keep it perfectly level while piloting. So it's not without flaws, this plan. Right, while that's going on, I'm going to go grab some more iron because I'm going to need some more. Those motors are taking a little while to build, so I may as well make myself useful flying over this way. Just check my inventory. Yep. Do have enough hydrogen to get there and back. Next bit I want to do is get this connector on here. Then I'll also need enough stuff for my drills. 1, 2, and 3. And then some forward thrust and a few extra batteries. Forward thrust. Didn't really want to put it on the top here if it's going to potentially block that conveyor port. So maybe I'll pop it off to each side and then I can put a frame in the middle if I... Okay. Whoa. Okay, that was a bit of lag. Now, those two can go there. And I suppose this works out all right. Get rid of those two blocks. Pop a square in there. Even though I was initially aiming to put those other ones low so that the thrusters on top wouldn't get knocked off, I guess I don't really have a lot of other spots to put these. That'll give me 4 forward thrusters. I should probably try and fit another 2 reverse on here somewhere. Suppose I could put them inside of that. So if I pop them there and there. That'll work. Alright. Let's get our drills on our build planner. Order up all the parts. See how much more hand mining I have to do. Alright, 1600 iron. That's like 2 trips, I think. Oof. That was not there from a moment ago. Oh, I should probably not go with 3 power. That would be a mistake. Now that I've gotten to this point of building a serious ship and having to do more hand mining just to get it done, I probably should have gone with a mini ship first and then gone the serious ship with the stuff from it. So, think I may have cost myself a little bit of time with this. I mean, nearing the hour mark in. But I do almost have my mining ship up and running. Then it shouldn't take me very long at all to get enough materials to build the basics of a base. And then grind it all back down again and put it in a cargo container and take it to space. Now for those of you thinking, this is looking mostly complete. But Splitsie seems to have forgotten something really important. That's because right until this moment I had. I really need to add a gyroscope or two to this thing. Probably 2. I had not edited that out, I had actually completely forgotten to do it. Which shouldn't surprise anyone. Yeah, survivor pod seems like a good spot to stick a gyroscope. It's a spot I'm not going to be grinding down in any hurry, so shouldn't end up having them go minesweeper on me. Then what I need to do is grab those. And I'm going to want to have a small cargo container on here. Probably stick the connector out this side, to be honest. So that should give me enough room to lock onto it. Do I have enough to build both of those? Don't think I do. I'm going to go collect some iron in this new retrofitted ship. We'll see how long this thing can fly for. Oh yeah, it's got plenty of power. Let's go grab some iron. I will likely need to get an ejector system on this quickly. Oh, nuts. Oh, I'll just collect a bit of stone when I do it this time. That's fine. It's not the worst thing in the world. And I do not have a GPS where my base is, but I should be able to find it again, even with my terrible sense of direction, because I've flown this route a few times. It's just to the left over that hill on the end. I'll put the reverse thrust on a separate group for coasting as well, but I just wanted to get moving quickly so that I could keep moving quickly. Okay. So once we're turning sideways, don't put the drills on. Oh, ouch. It's not happy when I've got the drills working. Definitely gonna need some extra battery power on this thing. Probably some lights too. The survival kit's working on the stone already. Brilliant. How much have we picked up? Because I don't want to overload myself too much. 18,000. I got a little bit more before I leave. Okay, might have gone too heavy. Jacked out our stone. So I definitely went over the top with this. Oh dear. This could all end very badly. So I've got my one respawn point in this tunnel with me. Let's... lights. Yeah, that's more like it. I do have lights. I forgot I had lights. About... have I got anything? No, it's just the weight of it. Okay. I may just need to offload some of that iron, I think. Yeah, this looks okay. Excellent. Draw myself a bigger exit as I come out. Oh, I really need that extra battery. And I really need to hook up to the base so that I can charge the battery I've got. Oh dear. Oh dear. Going down. Wait, my gear's on auto lock. Probably save me then, but still, I don't want it. I'm not too happy with my thrusters, but my thrusters can't work properly because of how little power they've got available to them. I knew I needed extra batteries, but I was hoping I could get away with this one just for the first trip, so I could collect a solid amount of iron and not have to go back there anytime soon. But it didn't quite work out as I'd intended. Didn't end too badly though. I didn't crash. And that's all we've got time for today. Next time, I guess we'll find out if I continue to be my own worst enemy, or if something more devious and horrible rears its ugly head. There's all that, and plenty more to come, and I will see you then.